We shall now talk about the first decision-making statement, the if statement in C. So first, let's understand what are statements. Statements are instructions followed by semicolon at the end. If I have more than one instruction, or even if I have zero instruction, but if I enclose them in the flower brace like this, that is the flower bracket like this, this is an example of a compound statement or a block. So here you see I have two instructions and I have enclosed it in a flower brace. So this is an example of a compound statement or block. If I ignore or do not put the block, this is an example of a simple statement. Then I can also have a null statement or an empty statement. An empty statement is simply a semicolon. So this is an example of an empty statement. Now what I am going to do here is, let us try to see what is the logic to check if an input number happens to be 0 or not. So suppose if I have to think in English to check whether a given input number is equal to 0 or not, the first step what I will do is I will say read in a number. Okay. So here what I am doing is I am asking the user enter an integer number. Then I am going to read the number. Then I will be required to take a call, or I will be required to make a decision. In the decision, what I am doing is I am saying if the number is equal to 0, then display the message the number is 0. So in this program, what I am doing is I am reading in a number and I am trying to print only if it is equal to 0. Otherwise, I am not doing anything else. So here, using a decision making statement, I was able to check in English whether the input number is equal to 0 or not. Now if I have to do it in C, take a look how it will turn out to be. The concept will be very similar, alright. So here what I am doing is, this is a piece of code to read in an input integer and display if the number equals to 0. So I am declaring an integer variable called as number. I am not giving it any initial value. I am asking the user enter an integer. User is going to enter some number. So using scanf, I am reading the number into a memory location. Then using the facility provided by C, I am comparing. If number equal to 0, that is, I am printing the message number entered is 0 and I am ending the piece of code. A couple of important points to notice. If you are using any expression after the if like this, it is a must that you use this round brackets or round parenthesis. Number one, this is not assignment, this is equality, because the value on the left hand side is being compared with the value on the right hand side. So be sure you do not use an assignment here. This is equality. So the two common mistakes which beginners make is forgetting to put this round parenthesis and using an assignment instead of equality. So this should give you a very good comparison of how the logic between how we think in English and how we write a program works. So here if you see, I have said print enter an integer. Here also I am saying enter an integer. Read a number, I am doing scanf. If I am doing if number is equal to 0. Instead of display, I am having printf and I am printing the message. So here if you see, this is an example of a Boolean expression because it's going to be true or false. Since in this case, let's say we entered the number 0, this condition would have been true or non-zero. Suppose I had entered, let's say 5. 5 is equal to 0 would have been false and it would have not printed any message. Another common mistake, do not put a semicolon after this parenthesis. That is incorrect because the semicolon is a null or empty statement. So the if will get associated with this empty statement. So how does a if statement work? This is the working of a if statement. It evaluates a Boolean expression. In our case, the Boolean expression was number equal to 0. Based on the result of the Boolean expression, that means if the result happens to be true, it will do some code. If it is false, maybe it will do nothing. So if it is true, the true block will get executed. If it is false, nothing will happen. This is known as the syntax of the if statement. So if the Boolean expression is true, it will execute zero or more statements. Again, important, you must enclose the expression in round parentheses. So this should hopefully help you understand how an if statement is used in C programming language.